Your news tips are worth money. Call in your tip at 223-6059. We'll pay you cash. This is WROI News.
WROI. It's time now to take a look at your local news. The news today is brought to you by Ulrich Heating and Cooling for reasonable prices, experience, and excellent customer service. Call them today at 574-223-6307 or on their cell at 574-727-0005. And by your Fulton County REMC, your Touchtone Energy Cooperative. Currently sitting at 85 degrees under mostly cloudy skies here in downtown Rochester. We'll have a look at your full weather forecast a little bit later on in your news. The Fulton County Commissioners met and heard the report from Sheriff Chris Sailors. Commissioner Rick Randstead was our guest on WROI and gave us this update on the overcrowding situation at the jail.
Right now, he's got 113 prisoners. It's booked in. He's got 83 in-house and 30 of them's out of county. Miami County is, as you well know, we've got a contract to hold 30. The 78% is male, 22% is female. We put together a jail committee. We met the other day. When we first come to the board, I would say half to three quarters of them was no jail. We don't need a jail. By the time last week when we had our meeting, everybody said that they've changed their mind, that they don't see how we can survive without building a jail.
The group has also looked at alternative sentencing, but Randstead told us that's not a cure-all.
The judge wanted to look at some alternative sentencing and some stuff like that, and quite frankly, he don't see it happening. He said a lot of times you sentence them and put them to probation and they're back in, they flunk their drug test. So how do you penalize them any more than without giving them a little jail time?
He went on to say there are other factors pushing this decision.
It basically was going to have to spend a bunch of money on our jail just to bring it up to where we could be using it. You know, I know we've got two or three lawsuits right now, people, you know, overcrowding, or they can't segregate, you know, the women from the males for obvious reasons. You got to separate people, and then that creates even more problems, and you got people that got to be sleeping on the floors or whatever just to get them in. And, you know, by rights, they can sue us if they want to, and that's where the real problem lies.
And again, that was Fulton County Commissioner Rick Randstead. In statewide news, an independent review of the Department of Child Services has 20 recommendations to make the department function better. Governor Eric Holcomb says he's going to push for all 20.
This is on my watch, and what's different is we're going to act on these recommendations. We said at the very outset that we were going to take it very seriously and that we would act. We would not veer off no matter how challenging the recommendations presented us. There's a lot of moving parts. There's a lot of implementation that has to occur. And as you improve in one area, that can draw down cost in another area. And it's synchronizing all of those actions that makes this one of the most challenging jobs on the face of the planet.
The governor says he wants to set aside $25 million up front to begin the process. A team of American runners will participate in the Run for the Fallen, starting in San Diego, California, and ending at Arlington National Cemetery in Maryland. On Thursday, June 21st, the run will be running through Rochester between 1:30 and 2 p.m. from Indiana 14 West from Winnemac, heading down Main Street to 9th, past the courthouse where three large flags will be placed. The run then continues to the VFW, where they call out a few names of fallen soldiers and then head to Akron to the Field of Flags for a small ceremony. The public is invited to stand along 9th Street at the courthouse to cheer the runners on or head to Akron for the ceremony. For more information on the run or to make donations, go to runforthefallen.org. Thanks to all who have served in every branch of our United States military. We'll be back with a look at your full weather forecast after this.
Ulrich Heating and Cooling Rochester offers expert sales and service in northern Indiana. Call 574-223-6307 for all your heating and cooling needs. They service all brands and all types of heating and cooling systems. For new heating and cooling products, Ulrich Heating and Cooling is proud to announce they now offer Armstrong Air, designed to deliver substantial durability, comfort, and energy efficiency. Armstrong Air is the professional's choice. Licensed, insured, and bonded, That's Ulrich Heating and Cooling, locally owned and operated for over 34 years.
Plan now to attend the Fulton County REMC's annual meeting Monday, June 25th at Rochester High School. When you attend, you'll receive a $25 bill credit for just registering. Registration is from 6 to 7 with free elephant ears, free cotton candy, free snow cones, and free bottled water. The business meeting begins at 7. Prize drawings after the meeting include one $200, four $100, six $75, eight $50, and $20 $25 bill credits. You must be present to win. Bring the kids for an open gym, bounce house, silly safaris free show beginning at 6, and prize drawings including a Razor Power Rider 360 electric tricycle with helmet, role play 12-volt uprider with helmet, and hoverboard with helmet. Kids must be present to enter drawings, but not to win prizes. Mark it on your calendar, the Fulton County REMC annual meeting at Rochester High School, Monday, June 25th. Plan now to attend this very important annual meeting. Your Fulton County REMC is your Touchstone Energy Cooperative.
And again, we have jumped to 87 degrees here in downtown Rochester under mostly cloudy skies. Argus is at 85. Culver is at 81. We see a chance of showers and thunderstorms the rest of the afternoon. Tonight, showers and thunderstorms are likely, a low around 69. Tomorrow, showers and thunderstorms likely, mainly up until about 2 p.m., then becoming cloudy with a high near 79. Tomorrow night, we see a chance of showers and thunderstorms up until about 2 a.m., then becoming mostly cloudy with a low around 65. On Thursday, a slight chance of showers and thunderstorms, a high near 79, a low around 63. On Friday, we see showers and thunderstorms likely mainly after 2 p.m., a high near 78 and a low around 66. And then on Saturday, chance of showers and thunderstorms, a high near 79 and a low around 64. It is 86 degrees in Culver, 85 in Argus, and 87 here in downtown Rochester. This has been a look at the forecast for Rochester and all of North Central Indiana. The news today was brought to you by Ulrich Heating and Cooling. Find out how you can save on your fuel bills with the latest in heating and cooling products. And by your Fulton County REMC, home of the Exceed Broadband Connection. Fulton County REMC, your Touchtone Energy Provider. For WROI News, I'm Paul Zartman.
Do you have the WROI News Tip of the Week? When you see or hear news happening, call 223-6059. If you have the top tip of the week, we'll pay you $10. That's 574-223-6059, 223-6059.